When I moved towards the city in Boston later on in life, there's not a lot of nature to see out there.
A short ferry ride from Boston is an oasis in Boston Harbor, Thompson Island.
It was shocking for me to know that just 5 minutes from where I lived, there's a whole another planet there, a whole different place I never even knew existed. And for the kids to come out here and like just see the pure joy in their face, there's nothing better than it.
Jalen Corsione was one of those kids that found joy through the Green Ambassador Program.
The Green Ambassador Program is a 3-year work opportunity. It was just such like a big change in my life. I want to serve the same kids that look like me and my family.
14-year-old Morgan was definitely very, very, very nervous to enter into this experience.
Morgan Crosby, another Green Ambassador alum, fell in love quickly with the beauty that is Thompson Island.
I think living out here has been like the coolest experience in my entire life. This is so quiet, it's so peaceful. I can literally take a few steps out my door and be instantly in nature.
Thompson Island's unique location is just one reason that Sylvia Watts McKinney decided to take on the role of CEO of Outward Bound on Thompson Island, the first woman and woman of color to hold this position in 50-year history.
The space was once part of, and still continues to be part of, an indigenous culture. Thinking about the original inhabitants of this space, the way that they looked at land and used that land, they cherished the land. They didn't take anything away from it. So we gotta put it back, and we gotta make sure that as we put it back, we also grow a community of love.
Knowing that all this beauty is out here, and like people like us growing up don't get to see it often, and a lot of us don't even know it exists. Because like I said before, it's important that people know, especially people of color, that there's nature all around and that they need to preserve it.
However, in the midst of this beauty, the effects of climate change are evident in the eroding areas, making the island smaller every year.
Seeing it firsthand is really scary.
I really feel like this is a place where people feel safe and really learn a lot about themselves, and to think that it's not going to be here for those moments, it's really hard to think about.
Which is why the work Morgan and Jalen are doing on Thompson Island is so important.
The Green Ambassadors do everything from invasive species removal to interning with other departments around the island.
It's a lot of science and like learning hands-on science, specifically putting them into the salt marsh and letting them learn about ecosystems, about different food webs.
Climate change is real. And we will be producing young people from this program who will have a certain expertise to be able to sit at the table.
Young people like Morgan and Jalen know exactly what's at stake and why preservation is the key.
They just kind of get to bask in its beauty, you know, and take it in and make and create moments for themselves that they'll like remember.
The biggest defining moment of my time on the island probably has to be that first sunset I saw on the dock, the very first time I stayed the night on Thompson Island. There's really nothing better than like seeing your city that you grew up in a whole different light. To see all of like the different colors overshadowing all the Boston skyline was beautiful. Coming to the island and everything that you've ever wished and hoped for and dreamed for being right there for you, there's nothing more magical than that.
For the PBS NewsHour Student Reporting Labs, I'm Sophia Ortiz from Thompson Island, Massachusetts.